First, we have to select a mechanical part design. Then select a plane which you want to sketch here. Select a rectangle center type and draw it rectangle for the required amount of dimensions. Exit the workbench. Apply the pad definitions. Give the force limit of your pad based upon your requirement. Then we have to select a flat face and go to the sketch workbench. We are going to draw a line here, so select a polyline and draw the polyline at a corner of flat face. Make sure you have to extend the line for maximum. Try to extend the line at maximum value. Then you have to just exit the workbench. Again, you have to select a flat face and go to the sketch. Just you have to try a center axis for make the mirror element. Then you have to select a line which was created previously and go to the mirror command. Just select our corresponding center axis. Exit the workbench. Just hide the unwanted planes. Then we are going to create a two planes which is normal to both lines. So select a reference element plane. Make sure you have to select a type as normal to curve. Then select our corresponding curve and a point. Just repeat the procedure for another line. Go to the reference element and select a plane and follow the procedure which we created previously. Then click OK. Just select a plane one by one. We have to draw a profile. So select a plane, go to the sketch. Now we are going to draw a profile here. So select a circle and draw a circle which is normal to the curve. Give the corresponding dimensions. Then we have to just apply the coincident constraints between a circle and curve. Click OK, just exit the workbench. Then we have to draw a one more profile for another curve. So just select a plane of another curve. Go to the sketcher workbench. Here we have to select a circle profile. Draw the circle profile which is normal to the curve. Apply the corresponding dimensional constraints. Then we have to apply the coincident between center of circle and a point of curve. Go to the geometrical constraints, apply the coincident. Just click OK. Then exit the workbench. Just hide the unwanted planes. Now we have here two profiles with the two gate curves. So we have to apply the slot option. So select a slot. Select our corresponding profile. Profile is nothing but profile is a circle. Then we have to select a center curve. Center curve is a line. Then click OK. Now our slot is applied successfully here. Then repeat the same procedure for another curve. Select a corresponding circle and a center curve. Then click OK. Now we are going to apply the transformation features for creating an knurling. So go to the insert, select a transformation features, select a rectangular type pattern. Here we have to specify the number of instances to be produced and click a reference element. Reference element is the edge of the rectangular box. Make sure the objects to be pattern is 1D slot. Click the slot 1 to be pattern. Change the direction of applying the patterns. Then we have to specify the number of instances to be produced. Then we have to specify the in-between spacing of pattern. Just click OK after creating a pattern. Now we are doing the same procedure for slot 2. Go to the insert, click the transformation features and select a rectangular type pattern. Now we are enter the number of instances and in between spacing. After that you need to select your objects to be patterned as slot 2. Click a slot 2 in a specification tree. Just click OK. Now our knurling is successfully created. Just you have to apply the material based upon your requirement for aesthetic look. To get the regular updates of my video, please subscribe in my channel. Just change the color. Which is give you a maximum aesthetic look. Now the knurling is successfully achieved here. To get the regular updates of my video, please subscribe in the channel. Don't forget to click notification symbol. Thanks for watching. Inshallah, we will meet in next video. First, we have to select.